So having we'll now go on to the second part, which is simplify. Okay? So practice set 3.3, simplify. See the first question. Okay? Where we have to find out the cube root of 27 upon 125. So what is the cube root of 27? I told you all to by heart or to memorize. So cube root of 27 is 3. So that means it will be 3 into 3 into 3. What is the cube root of 125? 125 cube root is 5. So you can write 5 into 5 into 5. So out of 3 threes, 1 3 will come out, and out of 3 fives, 1 5 will come out. So the answer is 3 upon 5. Is it clear? So very simple, the cube root of 27 is 3, cube root of 125 is 5, if you know it by heart. So the answer, you can get the answer very quickly. Let's see the second one. The second is slightly different. So let's see, cube root of 16 upon 54. Now, do you have a cube root of 16 in this list? No. What about 54? Is 54 there in this list? No. So there is no cube root for 16 and what? 54. So in this case, what do you do? So in this case, you have to simplify this number. Okay? So how do you simplify this number? By finding the factors. So there is no cube root of 16 or no cube root of 54. So you break it up. So what are factors? 15, 16, 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. What is the factors of 54? So it will be 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. Let's check. 2 3s are 6, 6 3s are 18, 18 3s are 54. 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16. Now what, can you cancel anything? Yes, I can cancel 2 and 2. So what is, how many 2's you have now? 3 2's. So what is the cube root of 3 2's? 1 2. What is the cube root of 3 3's? How many 3's will come out? 1 3. So the answer is 2 upon 3. Okay. So sometimes there is no direct cube root possible. So you will have to write the factors and simplify it. Okay. You have to cut it down. Or you can directly do it this way also. Two 8's are 16 or 2 27's are 54. And what is the cube root of 8? Cube root of 8 is what? 2. What is the cube root of 27? 3. 27 ka 3. Okay, so that way also you can do it by simplifying it. Okay, you can by writing the factors or directly simplifying it. Let's move to the third sum. Okay, so the third sum. I'll add something in this sum so it becomes more clearer to you. Okay, so they are saying that if the cube root of 2, 729 is 9, as you can see, cube root of 729 is 9. Then they are asking you find the following. How to find the following? So what you have to find out? Let's see the first one. What you have to find out? They say you have to find out cube root of 0.00729. Okay. So let me add a few more sums. Let's see if I have to find out cube root of 0.729. And let's say I have to find out cube root of 0.. Don't get worried about, really, it's a very big decimal. No, don't worry, it's very simple. I'll just show you. It's very easy. If you know the, so if you, you know the cube root of 729, right? What is the cube root of 729? 9. So what do you do is, you first write 9. Because you know the cube root of 729 is 9. Now see the decimal place. After decimal and before 9, you just put some zeros. Okay? Now you count how many decimals are there. After the decimal point, how many places are there? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 decimal places. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what do? This 6, since it is a cube root, you divide the 6 by 3. So what do you get? 2. Now, in any number, where is the decimal place always at the end? So you have to move 2 decimal places. So 1, 2. So your decimal will come here. So what will be your answer? Your answer will be 0.09. Very simple. Is it clear? Okay? So 0.09. Now, let's do this one. Okay? So, as usual, what is the cube root of 729? 9. So you write 9 and put some zeros before that. Okay? Now what do you do next? Where is the decimal place here? It is at the end. Okay? Now, after decimal point, how many places are there? 1, 2, 3. So here how many places are there? 6. So 6 you divide by 3. Here how many decimal places? 3. So you will divide 3 by 3. Okay? 3 by 3. You will get what? 1 decimal place. So you only move 1 place. Here you move how many place? 2 place, because you got 2 decimal place. Okay? When you divide by 3. So my answer will be, so your decimal has come here. So my answer will be 0.9. Is it easy? Now let's see how to do for this. Again, what is the cube root of 729? So you write 9 and put some zeros, because before 9, before any number, if you put zeros, those zeros have no value. Okay? Now, where is the decimal place? As usual, at the end. Now, I will have to shift the decimal place. How many places are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 decimal place. So there are 9 decimal place. What should I do to the 9 decimal place? I have to divide by 3. Can you see? Here there were 6 decimal place, I divided by 3. Here there were 3 decimal place, I divided by 3. Here there are 9 decimal place. So 9 divided by 3. So that is so much? 3. So what will you do now? Here you push how many decimal place? 2. Because your answer was 2 when you get there. Here how many decimal place you pushed? 1. Here you push how many decimal place? 3. So 1, 2 and 3. So my answer will be, your decimal will come here now. So my answer will be 0.009. Is it clear? Is it clear? So I hope you understood this part, how to find the answer. So, but this working you have to do in the rough page. Don't do it on the teacher will get confused. So please do the working in the rough page. So this is the answer. Now let's move to the next one. Now the lesson is over. We have finished all the 3 practice sets. I'll just show you something in Vedic maths. How by using Vedic maths we can find the cube roots. We can find the cube roots. Okay. So let's see how we can find cube roots of numbers, no? Like from 11 cube to 99 cube. So any number which is a cube of 11 cube to 99 cube, we can find out using Vedic maths. So let's see how will you do it. So 1, what is the root when it is 1 is 1, when it is 8 it is 2, for 7 it is 3, for 4 it is 4, for 5 it is 5. For 6, it is 6. 7, it is 7. For 2, it is 8. For 9, it is 9. And for 0, it is 0. So if you see, if the cubes are ending with 8, the cube root also will be 2. For cube ending with 7, it will be 3. For cubes ending with 4, it will be 4. So 4, 4, 5, 5, 1, 1. So for 1, it is same. For 1, it is same. For 4, it is same. 5, 6, and for 9 and 10, the cubes are same. If it is ending with 1, the cube root also will end with 1. Ending with 4, cube root also ending with 4. 5, 5, 6, 6, 9, 9, 0 and 0. Okay? So let's begin now. And for what is the, only here is ulta. For 8 it is 2, for 2 it is 8, for 7 it is 3, and for 3 it is 7. So let's see how to do this sum. Very easy Vedic math. Using Vedic math, within 5 or 10 seconds, you can find the answer. So let's see, what is the last digit? First find the last, see the last digit. What is the last digit? 6. So this is a cube. You have to find the cube root. So look in the cube root column for 6. So in the cubes column, there is 6. 6 ending, what is the? It is 6. So you write 6. Now after you do this, you remove the last 3 digits. Okay? You remove the last 3 digits. What remains with you is 17. Now look where the 17 lies. 17 lies between 8 and 27, isn't it? The number 17 lies between 8 and 27. Choose the smaller between them, it is 8. Between 8 and 27 is 17 lies between 8 and 27. Who is the smaller number? 8. 8 ke samne kon hai? 2. So my answer will be 2. So my answer of that means the cube root of this number is 26. Let's see for this. What is the last digit? 3. So let's see, well, this is a cube. So in the cube for 3, where is 3 ending? Here, 3. For 3 ending, what is the cube root? 7. So for 3 ending, it is 7. So write 7. Then remove the last 3 numbers. Okay, after doing this. What remains? Always remove the last 3 digits. Last 3 digits. What remains with you is 103. Where does 103 lie? 103 lies between 64 and 125. So who is smaller between 64 and 125? 64. Is it clear? 103 lies between 64 and 125. So who is smaller? 64. 64 is who is opposite 64? Who is the cube root for 64? 4. So my answer is 47. Let's move on this. Again, look at the last digit. What is it? Is 5. So this is a cube. So look in the cube section. Where is 5? 125 is ending with 5. For 5, what is the cube root? 5. So write last digit 5. Then remove this last 3 digits. Okay. What remains with you? 166. Where is 166 lying? It lies between 125 and 216. So who's smaller? 125. Who's opposite 125? 5. So my answer for this will to the cube root of 166375 is 55. Let's go to the last one. What is the last digit? 9. So which cube is ending with 9? 729. What is the opposite of, what is cube root for 9? So cube root for 9 will be 9. So write 9. Last digit 9. Then remove the last 3 digits as you know. We always remove the last 3 digits. What remains with you is 970. Where does 970 lie? 970 is between 729 and 1000. So who's smaller? 729. So 729, who's opposite 729? 9. So my answer is, so cube root of 970299 is 970299 is 99. Okay boys, I hope you all understood this. I know if you feel I've gone little fast, please rewind it and try to understand, because this is a very easy method to find out cube roots using Vedic maths. Okay, so just go through this and learn, and to get the cube roots easily you can use Vedic maths. Thank you very much. God bless you.